Hello everyone, it's Joy from Artful Homemaking, and I just wanted to tell you how our first week of school went. This past week we started our first week of school for the 2017-2018 school year, and it went pretty well. I was surprised that it actually went as smoothly as it did. We had a number of setbacks and difficulties that happened right before we started our new school year. I already had it all planned, and like the week before, my father-in-law passed away, and so that was very sad. And he was 88, so you know, he was older, but you know, you're never really prepared for a loved one to die. So we had to travel out of town to be there for the funeral and for family things, and so that kept us busy the whole week before we started school. And then my second daughter turned 16 the day before we started school, so we celebrated her birthday on Saturday and Sunday. We did two different things, and then we planned to start school on Monday. And I could have changed it. I could have switched dates and moved it back a few days or even a week if I wanted to. I could have done that, but I wanted to carry on with the plan that I had and go ahead and just power through it and get started. Part of the reason I wanted to get started is just because every year it seems like there are so many things that come up towards the end of August, and it's just hard to fit everything in. So I just kind of wanted to get a head start. So we went ahead and started, and it actually went really well. My oldest daughter had just recently started a new job. She's working full time, and because she graduated this past spring. So she was going to her new job, and we were starting our new school year, and it was a little bit complicated logistically, and then we have a cold going around. But surprisingly, it went so much better than I expected it to, actually, and I think it's because of all the planning, all the time I spent planning out our school year. And I spent way more time this year planning than I ever have before, and I usually put quite a bit of thought and plan and prayer into it. But this year, I just felt really compelled to just keep thinking through every detail and keep trying to work it out in my mind how this is going to look in our home. Because sometimes I plan things and they just don't turn out the way I hope they're going to. It's a disappointment or just not a good fit. And this year, I really put a lot of time and effort into it, and I really think it paid off. And part of it, I planned it in my Erin, Condren planner, and I feel like I can't say enough good things about this planner. Of course, I wish she would design a planner specifically for homeschoolers, but there's not that much that you have to change, and it's super easy to change it, in my opinion, and it's so worth it because it makes me want to look through it and it makes me want to plan. So I used my planner extensively this year and really customized it to fit me and our homeschool. And I made my plans, and then I went to the computer and I made a, like, what do you call it? Like a graph or something. Yeah, kind of like just a schedule for each child every day. So they'll have like their subject and what the lessons they need to complete, and their general lessons, like do one lesson of math every day, and they can check it off. I put a little circle so they could check it off. So that's been working really well for my three older children, my 11th grader, 8th grader, 6th grader. They're able to work independently and use their little checklist forms to check off what they need to do, and then if they have questions, they can always ask me. But it's working really well, and that's something I'm doing that's new this year. And so, and the next thing that I did that kind of made it so that I think we had more success than we've had in other years was I am kind of not doing everything all at once. So when we started the school year, we started kind of in an easy, relaxed kind of way. And we're going to add in more stuff this coming week, next week. So I'm really looking forward to seeing how that goes. And I think it's going to pay off because, you know, we've already gotten started, and yet we're going to add some new things in. So I think it's going to work out really well. And I'm just thrilled that it has turned out as well as it has, and that it's going, you know, smoothly for you know, the ages that I have. And we also, I realized after we got started, there was a logistical situation. We have a homeschool room in our basement, and that's where I love to keep all the homeschool stuff because I like keeping the clutter out of our little kitchen. I mean, our kitchen is an eating kitchen, but it's not super big, and there's not a lot of space to store homeschool stuff. So I loved having everything downstairs, but my older children kept gravitating toward the kitchen table, especially my oldest. And I realized I really need a place where I can just have school with my youngest, and I thought it would work better. So I moved a bookshelf upstairs into our dining room, which I didn't really want. We've had this before and I didn't want it in there, but I thought through it all and I think it's gonna work out much better. So my plan is to have breakfast together and have morning time all together, and then my older children can do their schoolwork that they do independently upstairs, and my youngest and I will go downstairs and work in the schoolroom. And so far that is working so well. My youngest does better one-on-one, and you know, with older siblings, sometimes they think some of his stuff is silly, or they might, you know, it's distracting to them. That's really why we did it, because it was distracting my older students, because I need to be doing a lot of teaching and talking with my youngest, and my older children need silence to, you know, focus on geometry and, you know, history and all the things they're trying to read. So far that's working really well, and I'm really excited about it. And it did require an adjustment in my mindset of keeping the dining room just for, you know, dining and keeping homeschool out of it, but it's just working well, and it's trying to work with what we have in our kind of smaller home. And so I'm really happy with how it turned out. I'm hoping that each week that we go by that my planning is just going to pay off more and more. So I hope your week went well if you've started school yet. If you haven't started yet, I would just encourage you, keep planning and keep thinking about it, and I think it really pays off. At least this year for me, it's really been paying off big time, and I'm really thankful that it was worth it all, because I sacrificed a whole lot of time to do all that planning. So anyway, I just wanted to share how our school week went and say that I hope your school week, as you get started with a new school year, I hope that it goes well, and just stay encouraged and stay positive about it. I can say, as a mom who's graduated one, and I've got another one that will graduate in a couple of years, I mean, she's this year and next year, but next year will be her last year, so just it's all worth it, and it will all pay off, and just be encouraged, and I hope you have a great first week of school. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.